Hi, I'm Naomi, and today we are going to learn how to use Camtasia's new reflection feature. It's a nice basic feature with just a couple tiny quirks. You'll learn how to use this feature in a variety of ways, from using it as a beginner to an advanced use of it. Although we will be concentrating on text, everything we go over today can be used on objects and people. So let's start at the beginning. We'll add a text annotation, which you can find under annotations, and I already have one set in my favorites. I like to uncheck auto resize text to have more control. I'll make this wider, change the font to bold. I'm also going to change the horizontal spacing to 0.10. I'll then change the text to top shelf VA. I'll right click on the box and select apply box style text. Let me adjust the font size so it is all on one line. Now we will go to the visual effects and add the reflection to the text. That's kind of far away. No problem, we'll adjust the distance here. Okay, we have run into one of the little quirks. It won't move any closer to the text. Sometimes this happens when you have turned off the auto resize text, adjusted the text as I did here, which forced the bounding box to be larger. When I decreased the text size to fit, the text fit, but the height of the bounding box did not. So here is the easy fix. You can simply click on the bounding box and adjust the height. Now you can easily adjust the distance to your liking, directly under or a bit of a distance away. You can also adjust the opacity. Now let's look at 3D and another small quirk with the reflections feature. This is a very basic way of making a 3D effect. We'll go to visual effects and add a drop shadow. For the angle, click on the right middle square. Put the opacity to 100% and the blur down to 0. I'll put the offset to 13. Now let's add the reflection. Adjust the distance. Where is the 3D reflection? That's quirk number 2. There is a simple workaround. Let's remove the reflection. Now group the text with itself by pressing Ctrl plus G or right-clicking and selecting Group. Okay, add the reflection back to the group. There it is, the 3D, and you can do the same as before, adjusting the distance and the opacity. Now, what about the text that really looks like 3D? I'm going to give you a quick little bonus lesson on how to do this, and we'll then look at some creative ways you can work with the reflection effect. I've made our background dark for this part of the lesson, as you will see how it is beneficial later. I also changed the word to subscribe as, well, a not very subtle reminder to subscribe to the channel. You'll also notice I changed the horizontal spacing to 0.12 to add a little more space for the 3D effect. The first step is to duplicate this track by pressing Ctrl plus D. Then click on the track below. The track on top is in front of the track below it. We are ultimately going to do this process 10 times. I like 10 layers, but you can do this process the number of times you prefer. Let's change this color to one a little darker. You can simply move the color picker circle a little lower. I know exactly what color I want since I did this before, so I will paste it in here. We can now use our right arrow key to move this text asset over by pressing it 5 times and the up arrow key once to move up by 1. Now we will do the same process again. Ctrl plus D to duplicate. Click on the lower track since it is the one behind. Change the color with the color picker circle to one a little darker. Then use our right arrow key to move this over by 5 and up arrow key to move by one. Repeat this process until you have 10 tracks. Once you have 10 tracks, group them together. Rename the group. It's always a good habit to name your groups. Let's remove all the empty tracks. Let me enlarge this for you. Now go to Visual Effects and add a reflection. Let's adjust the distance and take a look. Now, as we can see here, when up against the word, the 3D reflection is slightly off. It doesn't appear flat. This can be handled in one of two ways. Either keep the reflection a bit of a distance from the word so people don't pick up the difference, or my preference is to move the reflection further up under the text until that small gap disappears. But as we can see here, there is still a gap, even at minus 100. So what do we do? Here's the trick. Duplicate the track, remove the reflection from the top track. Let's rename the bottom track Bottom Subscribe Reflection. Let me zoom in here again. Now we'll use our up arrow key to move the reflection up until the gap is completely gone. Let's zoom back out. Whoa! Obviously, we need to hide the actual bottom word, but keep only the reflection. Let's add a rectangle to the width of the canvas and have the bottom edge touch the bottom edge of the text subscribe. Let's move that to the track between the top subscribe track and the bottom subscribe track. Now let's add the media matte visual effect and change it to alpha inverted. Let's take a look and see if we need to adjust the matte track up or down any. That looks pretty good. Let's adjust the opacity of the reflection. The last step is to group the matte and reflection together, then rename the group. Notice how all the sharp edges are all the way to the end, no matter the opacity. They don't fade out. If we prefer a fade, how can we fix that? It's actually quite simple. I made a 1920 by 1080 gradient matte object in Photoshop. I'll place this one on the track between the two subscribes. Turn it around so the white is on the bottom. Then add a media matte visual effect and change it to luminosity inverted. I'll now adjust the gradient matte until I see the bottom of the reflection fade to my liking. I may also adjust the top of the gradient matte. I can also go into the bottom subscribe reflection group and adjust the reflection opacity. I can go back to the luminosity matte and make any other adjustments. So we went from this to this. Okay, how about giving this a bit of a neon light feel? Very easy. Let's go to Visual Effects and add a drop shadow to the top subscribe track. Click on the center square for the angle. Change the color to a lighter pink, the opacity to 100%, and the blur to 20. Now we will copy the drop shadow effect from the top subscribe track. Go into the bottom subscribe reflection group and right-click on the inner group bottom subscribe reflection and select Paste Effects. I'm going to change the opacity to 15. Now the word subscribe looks like it is lit up and the backlight is also reflecting a little from the bottom of the word subscribe. All right, how do we get the reflection to fan out rather than just go straight down? Let's first add my grids to the track above. I am going to lighten these a little. I'm also going to add another grid above this, adjust its location, color, and opacity because I will probably need to finesse angles a little finer. If you don't have these grids, I will put the link to them in the description below. If you want to support the channel, a small donation would be appreciated, but if you can't afford a donation, they are free. Let's click into the bottom subscribe reflection group. Select the inner bottom subscribe reflection group and press Alt to crop the top of this to just above the word subscribe.
The next step is to click on the corner pin mode icon at the top and move the top corner pins down and inward. Click back on the edit icon, click on the main timeline tab, hide the grid tracks for a moment. Now move the bottom subscribe reflection group upwards with the up arrow key. Turn the grid tracks back on. Go back to the bottom subscribe reflection group tab. Click on the shape mat and bring it down so it covers the letters of the word but not the reflection. Select the bottom subscribe reflection group and click again on the corner pin mode icon. Now slightly adjust the bottom corner pins so the reflection words match up to the right and left of the main word. Click back on the edit icon. Click back on the main timeline tab. Hide the grid tracks. If needed, go back to the bottom subscribe reflection tab and make any minor adjustments. Close out of that tab and make any adjustments you want for the horizontal gradient mat. You are ready for the next advanced step, making a 3D angled V-shaped word. I have set the horizontal spacing to 0.10 for this example. Now, if this was a four-letter word, we would be able to split it in the center, but here the letter C is in the center. We'll move the word to the left until the letter C is at the vertical center. Now duplicate this and rename the top track as left subscribe and the bottom as right subscribe. Using your cropping tool, crop the top track to the center left. Crop the lower track to the center right. Now add sets of grids like we did the last time and lock them down. Let's select the left and right assets on tracks 2 and 3 and move these down with our arrow key until the text bottom hits the grid line. We'll select the left side track and click on our corner pin mode icon. We'll adjust the top corner down and in, keeping note how many down and across the grid lines. We'll do the same for the bottom. Now we'll do the same for the lower right side track. Let's select both tracks to make sure we have aligned the corners the same. Hide the grids for a moment to see how things look. We see there is a space between the left side and the right side. The easiest way to fix this is to simply move the left to the right by a couple clicks of the arrow key, the right by moving it to the left with a couple clicks of the arrow key. Group both the left side and the right side together. Duplicate it and rename the top group as top subscribe and the lower group as bottom subscribe. We'll go back into the bottom subscribe group, select the left subscribe side and turn on our corner pin mode. Go to visual effects and add the reflection to the left subscribe. Adjust the distance and put the opacity to 50%. Copy the reflection effect and paste it to the right subscribe group. Let's click on our main timeline and turn our grids back on to help guide us. Back to the bottom subscribe tab. Let me zoom in here a little to see better. Essentially, our objective here is to adjust the angle so the reflection fans out on each side. Click on the left subscribe group and click on the corner pin mode. Adjust the angle, keeping track of how many you move down and over. Let's go to the main timeline tab and hide the grid so we can see our C reflection. Turn on the grid again if needed. Back to the bottom subscribe tab and adjust until you get what you want. Simply keep tweaking with the grids on and off until you like what you see. Now, let's add a mask to the bottom subscribe group. We'll add two empty tracks above track 2. Add two rectangular boxes to cover the left side and the right side. Group the two together and rename as bottom mat. Let's hide the top subscribe group for just a moment. We'll now add the media mat visual effect as an alpha inverted. Let's turn the top subscribe track back on. Now it is simply a matter of going into the bottom mat group, turning on the corner pin mode, and adjusting the bottom of the mats to the bottom of the text. Let's zoom in and see if we want to make any minor adjustments between adjusting the bottom subscribe group or the bottom mat group. Looks close enough to pass for me. Now add the horizontal gradient above the mat track. Add the luminosity inverted mat and adjust as needed. Let's light this thing up. Add the drop shadow to the top subscribe group. Select the angle center, set the opacity at 100% and blur at 20. Change the color to a light pink. Copy the drop shadow effect, paste it to the bottom subscribe group, and change the blur to 15.
Then we can make any minor adjustments to the horizontal gradient until we like what we see. I hope you had the opportunity to watch my previous Camtasia training videos on the corner pin mode and how to create realistic shadows and the motion path video. Now, with this reflection training video, I think you will find all of these features opening up another creative opportunity for you. Okay. I'm not going to be a mother hen here, but seriously, if you haven't subscribed by now and hit that notification bell, after staring at that word all this time, I'll simply say thank you for being here, and until we meet again, have a wonderful day.